You see too many Will Flamingo last 2 days, now you see the fake one.
Do you enjoy the trip?
Yeah.
You too?
Hey, good house.
小姐，我健康。
Hi, Zach.
Okay, now go.
Được theo hả? Không có chẳng đi hả? Sao? Thu lái đi tập quay phim.
Have to remind yourself of your reach 36 inches tall to ride this ride.
once again, your stop must be at least 36 inches tall, seating 3 people per car. Unless you have an even advised that food and drink are not allowed on SkyCruiser. For your convenience, stroller parking is available at the entrance of this ride. Once again, your stop must be at least 36 inches tall to ride this ride. Thank you for your cooperation. Remain seated, please. Spider-Man attention doubles.
No.
Okay. Not yet. Say hi,
Sumjo. Hi. Hi,
I'm a cool and lying on my dad.
look at this. Look at this tiny, tiny. Oh, but that's a real tree. Yeah, that's a real.
It's kind of halfway done.
Also frequent dusting. That's when they also they're a bit bigger in size overall, 13,000 to 15,000 pounds. But those ears definitely stand out. And you notice those ears almost shaped like the continent of Africa? I'm sure you remember where they're from. And they use those ears as air conditioning systems. They've got lots of blood vessels flowing through them, so they flap the ear.
Because both the males and females need visible tusks. So they use them to dig for water. And often in Africa, water's kind of scarce.
What's that? They weren't exact.
They've got an elephant training demonstration.
We're in store for it. It is a distant look, but we'll get a much closer look as we move out to the field. Huge enclosure. And we've got 5 enclosures like that. So lots of room for the animals to run around. And presenting the animals this way. So let's take a look on the right here. The zebras are keeping watch. I wonder if they're hearing the noises over in the lion enclosure and wondering what's going on over there. They've all got their heads turned.
Very social animals. They've got a large enclosure. Actually, most of their enclosure is on the other side of this hill, so they have a pretty large area to roam around, but they all like to hang out in the same general area with their friends.
Side. Do you notice how the stripes from one zebra will actually blend into the stripes of the other? Sometimes when in a close group, it's hard to tell where one zebra ends and the next one begins. They exhibit disruptive coloration. And that helps them in the wild, because when the predators approach, they have a hard time picking out one animal to prey upon. Don't know if they're going for a throat or a rump or what. A little confused. Not the rhino.
Elephant.
Not the elephant. It's the hippopotamus.
Wow. Hippos, yeah, they're really territorial about the waterways. They overturn boats on the rivers and drown.
Two words, if they're far away though. Those are greater Indian rhinos, and we'll take a look at them again in a moment. Lots of little babies. But those little gazelles have a great advantage. Tiny and tan is a great way to be if you live in areas with lots of dry grass or sand. Because when you're tiny and tan, you curl up in the side of a dry grass hill and remain motionless, you practically disappear. Tan side, there's a brand new baby Eastern Kiang up here, born about a week ago. He's curled up on the side of the hill. Follow the fence line up to the top and the lower elevations. That way they avoid extremes in temperature. Vertical. Now, the very distinctive thing about these greater Indian rhinos, first of all, look at that skin. They look like they're wearing plates of armor. It does folds in their skin. And the theory is those folds in their skin help them to radiate their heat better. It gives them greater skin surface areas, a greater area for evaporative cooling. Also, look at the horn on these guys. They've just got one horn, and it's kind of a short, stubby horn. They bury their face in the food trough. There is one out there with just one horn. These are the Arabian oryx. Now, these are desert animals. They've got adaptations to desert life. Everybody knows if you're going to spend a lot of hooves. They have very flat, shovel-like hooves that help them maneuver over the sandy areas where they live.
Born on July 22nd. Mom's name is Godavari. Also some spotted Chica deer. Let's see who's just up ahead here. Oh, mom and baby rhino heading out of the water hole, coming up the hillside.
About 100 pounds of weight gain a month during the first year after birth. Now that fuzzy white rear end, that's... Now those antlers look kind of strange, don't they?
Now there's one back there nursing for mom. Looks like he's a little too big to still be nursing. Mom's not having it. Hurts. If you travel in a large herd, you don't want big outstretched horns that point out because you might accidentally gore your neighbor. Herds have these compact horns that are turned in or pointed upwards. Now here on this next hill, there's a nursery herd of young Kenya Impala laying down the grass. There's a little tiny one just to the left of that nursery herd. But these Kenya Impala antelope all have their babies to see little heart-shaped noses.
Yeah.
And you might notice they have a little bit of a sheen to their coat. They look kind of oily. And actually, they are oily. They have a protective oil in their coat to protect them from the water. Since they live near water in most cases, if a predator approaches and they want to run out into the water to avoid the predator, then that's oil. On the hillside, I see there's a little cordate right in East Africa. Those usually stand between 15 and 17 feet tall. You notice how mellow they look? Even when they're on the move, giraffe always seems so calm. Climbing up the hill, one of the keepers. Now, every day, the keepers have to come out here and count these animals. They have to make sure they're all present. They look for new births. They look for injured animals. And it's tricky in here because... Now, just to introduce you to who's in here, down on the ground level, just past the second fence line, you see most of the animals down here on the ground level are Himalayan tar goats. They have little claw horns. And you may also see some sheep up in the hills that have a chocolatey... They play a very important role out in the wild. Once a pride of lions has finished their kill, that carcass leaves them. As a result of that war, these animals are being wiped out so quickly, it's believed they may be extinct within just a couple of years. And that would be a terrible loss because they're very...